we have a huge spoiler warning, as in like a big rear end on your cars.
That's the wrong type of spoiler going.
Okay, but it's still a big spoiler one.
Yeah.
So, if you haven't seen Ant-Man the Wasp, or you don't want to get, like, the movie spoiled, we might, like, accidentally say stuff, so be warned.
Yeah.
So, we're gonna give you 3 seconds to, like, leave if you don't want it to be spoiled, okay?
Yeah.
Uno. Dos. Trace. Still here? Okay, let's continue. Ant-Man and the Wasp was directed by Peter Reed. The main characters are Hank Pym. Okay, I'm gonna just continue. Hope Van Dyne and Scott Lang.
And also there's Stanley.
Yeah, Stanley makes a cameo in like this movie and pretty much every other single Marvel movie. So, to continue, the actors are Michael
B. Jordan.
No, not that. It's, it's like Michael something. I forgot the last name for Hank Pym. And it's Paul Rudd and Evangeline Lilly. The movie takes place after the events of Ant-Man 1 and before Infinity War. But, like, there's a post-credit scene which kind of is similar to it.
Yeah, we'll get to that.
Yeah, we'll get to that later at the end.
Don't skip that. It's bad.
Yeah. The next thing is that... where was I? Oh, yeah. It was after the events of Ant-Man 1. Where after he escaped going subatomic, Hank Pym starts to wonder if he could escape, maybe his wife could too, or could still be alive. So he tries building a machine to be able to go into the quantum tunnel, into the quantum realm, and come back out. So he needs Paul Rudd to come back to his lab to help him find his wife. The main villain is a character named Ghost. Ghost is a character who can phase through objects. Kind of like, if my hand was here, like, Ghost can do this, like.
Yeah, but except he couldn't go around.
Yeah, except this way I did this to simulate it, but in reality it'd go like, joom, joom. I can't do that, so I'm just going around.
Ow.
So I'm just going around.
My head. That hurt.
Anyways, next up is... There's a funny scene that I like where it was like, you know how in school you have rules, right? One of those rules is probably don't draw on walls, and then the girl's like, yeah? Well, your dad in Germany, your dad drew on the walls with Captain America. And that violates part of our Sokovia Accord, paragraph 13, subject 3 or something. It's like, you're great with kids, aren't you? It's like, yeah, I know, right? It's like, it wasn't me. I just broke the fence. And now, in fact, how else do you entertain kids? I have to do this to do it. And then he pulls up a card, like, and it makes it disappear, like, okay, but we're still gonna have you on house arrest. Three days. And he's like, me? Also, how'd you do that? And he's like, really, dude? What would your favorite scene be?
The same thing.
Oh, do you have any other favorite scenes?
Where they get to use the Hot Wheel cars and turn them and you can drive them.
Oh yeah, the Hyundai.
It's like the most weirdest scene was the part where he was big and then he was like,
I'm gonna go sleepy.
And then he fell.
What? Was it 10 minutes? Oh, this video's odd. does have a happy ending, and I recommend this movie to any fans of, like, physics or sciences and stuff, and superhero movies, and...
No, but none of this is real.
Size.
Movies all fake.
Perception of size?
Or my...
Me? No, no, don't ruin it for the kids. So if you should watch if you like science movies or perception of size, so like making an ant appear like huge, like this big, like here, like the here.
Ow.
Yeah, here.
Yeah. Here.
How does that hurt you? I just literally tap you.
It's twisting on my hair.
Next, should we get into the
ending scene? Because we've talked about everything else.
No.
Do you have anything else to cover?
Yeah. Oh yeah. Ant-Man and Wasp's powers are that they can shrink and grow. Kind of what makes him Ant-Man. He also has Giant-Man, which, as you can tell by his name, he becomes huge. In fact, 63 feet. Oh yeah, and perception of size, when I mean that, is like, if you have a huge building, right? Like a 15, 30 story building, right? If you toss that thingy, it becomes
a
suitcase.
He's
like from this big to like 30 feet tall.
He's like half
60
feet
tall.
He could like slow the Titanic.
That'd be funny if he was on Titanic, he just shrinks the iceberg. And then it doesn't crash. That'd be weird. And it's like, iceberg ahead! Another iceberg ahead! But I'm getting ahead. So, and talking about off-topic stuff. Do you have anything else we should cover? Yeah, there's this thing called quantum entanglement, which is this thing where Scott and Miss Van Dyne, Hank's wife, and Hope Van Dyne's mom, are like, Scott and them are quantumly entangled by, like, because he put an antenna in his brain, kind of, like, so that way anytime they are about to enter the quantum thing, she can, like, he has, like, a message or vision, and then, yeah, it's kind of weird. It's like, he's, like, one time it's like, what's happening? It's like, I've waited 30 years, I have 30 years to think about it. And it's like,
oh, I love you, Hank.
And then it's like, but it's Scott still, so it's, like, weird, because it's like,
aw.
And it's like, I love you too, Jelly Bean. And it's like, I got no message. Wait.
How do we go from there
to here?
He turns into Scott.
Yeah, and then he turns back into Scott again. And he's like, wait, I got no message. And it's like, wait, how do we get from there to here? And it was this like quantum time or something. And it's like, oh yeah, and then this thing is like, they put the mind control so that way he replicates everything that Scott does, like including drumming. Resting in the shower.
The ant.
Yeah, the ant. He just rests in the shower, like in the bathtub. He does drums. He does other random stuff that Scott does. And then, yeah. To replicate it, and then the FBI don't get suspicious of him. And then, now we are going, proceeding on to the very final scene.
I have a funny scene. There's a thing that Hank guy has. It's like, can I have one? It's like, no. It's like,
oh yeah.
Can I have one?
No. Altoids. It's like, can I have, please, can I have an Altoid? No. It's like, you know. And it's like, reach for it. Well, you reach for it and he's like, no.
Ow.
And yes, that slap was genuine.
Ow.
I did not just fake it. I didn't go like, tick, tick, tick. And he's like, ow!
It's like this.
Now we are continuing on to the post-credit scene. It hints to what may happen at Mark at. We're going to the post-credit scene where it links itself to Avengers 4 and sets up. I mean, Avengers Infinity War and sets up for Avengers 4. I cannot speak. Avengers 4. It sets that up and connects to Infinity War. I'm trying to speak, but it's really hard to because, like, I'm mixing up all my words.
So the next thing is...
So, yeah, the connection is... What do you like to explain in some words?
Okay. You do the thing, like, the story at the end.
Okay.
And I'll do...
They go in to heal their friend Ghost, who they save from dying or fading from existence. So they need to get quantum energy in order to like give her like a healing boost, in some words. Then, as he goes small, he's about to go big again, or regular size, but then he hears a crackle on his radio. He's like, guys? Come on, don't play around. Come on, I need to get out of here. And then we zoom out of the quantum area to see that they're withered away and go like that new meme about like Infinity War was like, Mr. Stark, I don't feel so good. Withers away.
Yeah.
So it's like, Mr. Pym, I don't feel so good. The new model for Goldfish. The snap that smiles back. Goldfish. The snap that smiles back. And then the snap is we eat them. And now half of the population is gone.
Yeah, so you know how he snaps and everyone, like, the half of the universe dies.
He's gonna explain it in case. He's gonna explain it in case you didn't watch Infinity War.
Yeah. So there's a guy named Thanos. And there's infinity, there's something called infinity crystals.
Infinity stones, actually.
Yeah. Okay. So, as I was saying, if he gets all those, and he snaps, he can wipe out half the population of the universe. And so he snaps, and you know how someone told them that they withered away.
Yeah,
that's what happened to them.
Mr. Stark, I don't feel so good. And he withers away, invisibility.
Yeah, and then he stuck there, I guess. Yeah, so that's the end.
It leaves it on a cliffhanger where they're all withered away. Guys, help, please. So I think that either the Wii dude who's played by Michael Pena, or that Cassie is going to save him, and then he will help the other people. I guess maybe. So that's us analyzing it. I hope you enjoyed the video. Like the video if you want to see more. Subscribe if you want to see more videos. Share it with other people if you want them to see the same content that you did and you like the video. If you have any more movie suggestions, please comment down below or give any more suggestions. Smash the like button!
Also, subscribe and let me see any of our videos. Just look.
And comment down below if who was your favorite. Okay, question of this video is, what was your favorite character from the Marvel Universe? Or more specifically, the cinematic universe. That includes the X-Men from that one, the Quicksilver dude, and Guardians of the Galaxy, Avengers, Venom, Deadpool. So most of the characters.
Spider-Man.
Oh yeah, he's an
adventure.
Spider-Man.
Adventure.
Adventures.
Spider-Man.
Anders Man. I hope you like this video. And I'm saying bye-bye.
And we...